Isn't Jesus wonderful? Now, how many were here when I started teaching on the mystery of authority? The mystery of authority. When we talk about the mystery of authority, we're talking about the behind the scenes, secretive things that is hidden about this thing, but it has to be looked at the right way. You see, this is why, you know, the Bible gives that statement in Romans. It says, who art thou, O man, who argue with God? Are you more wiser than him? Did you make yourself or did he make you? It start mentioning things like that because sometimes God's ways are very mysterious, and a lot of them are so misunderstood by us because of the way he do things, and he has so many multiple purposes and levels of dealing with so many things at the same time when he's doing things that his ways are past finding out, like Romans declares. I mean, it's so brilliant. It's so high. Oh, the depths and riches of the knowledge of God. His ways are past finding out. And so sometimes when you don't get into the point of really just trusting him, you start to try to figure him. And that's what gets you in trouble instead of trusting. Are you hearing this here? One of the most important things I've learned about walking in not in authority, but submitting to authority is faith. You got to trust God when you're submitting to authority. You have to trust God more than you do when you have authority to walk and execute authority. How many understand that? I'm going to say it again. You have to have more faith in submitting than you do in executing authority. It's very easy to execute authority, but it is more difficult to submit to authority. The reason why God gives the easier ladder is because the first is harder. The first is what proves your validity or proves your worthiness of having authority, being able to submit to it. So say this to me. When I learn to master submitting to authority, then God gives me authority. God trusting you with authority is very easy, but he has to get you to the place to where you understand submission, that all authority given is because there is a system, a government. Are y'all hearing this here? I explained to you how that when Jesus came here on earth, how he did not rebel against the crown that was on Lucifer's head. For instance, he didn't disdain him. He didn't say, oh, you're a slew-foot devil, you know. He didn't treat him like that. He talked to him as a king, as a prince. He called him the prince of this world. Although the world was made by his father, he did not dishonor that crown on Lucifer's head. Number two, he submitted to the authorities of this world, even though they were wicked. He submitted himself unto death. Death is Satan's top lieutenant general. It is his major general. Death follows Satan. It follows hell too. Hell, both of them guys, they all together. These are generals in his army. These are his key strategy points. You may say, what are you talking about? Death and hell follow together. These are beings, evil spirits, evil top kings in Satan's kingdoms or his empire. And so in order to his real strategical war point is killing people and trapping them in death before they could ever repent and getting them to go to hell. That's why Jesus hold the keys of death and hell. He has both of those generals. That's Satan's strategical point of war, death and hell. Hell follows death, you see. And so the thing is, Jesus, these guys were in power on the earth. They it says death reigned from Adam to Moses. That's a person. Death reigned from Adam to Moses. Everybody who died, that's why they had to go to hell. That's why Jesus had to go to hell and get the other prophets, apostles, all the saints in hell. They were down there because after Adam's sin, I've taught y'all this, that crown fell off his head. The devil picked it up. He became legally the prince of this world. He was no longer just an archangel with power, and he had a kingdom up under the world, up under the earth. He now gained reign in the earth. He had the same power Adam had. So Jesus, the way God sent Jesus, was not to with swords to rise up a rebellion. That would have been wrong. He would have been fighting his own authority. God respects his own system so much that even though his crown and authority was up on a demon's head, he did it a certain way. And this is what people don't understand in this country. They don't understand the mystery and the importance of why God honors authority and why he stands by his choices, even when it looks like they're wrong. You got to understand that when God sets up a system, he don't change that system too quickly. Now, he can change and take the anointing very quick. He can remove his spirit, but his system, his government is an everlasting government. There is no end to it. See that? The government he has, there's no end to it. So when you come up against that, that's why the Bible says when you resist these powers, you receive damnation. That means a judgment sentence against thyself.